Hi kids! Today we're continuing with our puzzle sermon series with sermon number 2. We're going to think about other tough questions that you might have about Jesus. Have you ever thought about this question? Is Jesus God? Wait, I thought Jesus came to earth as a man. But then, the Bible also said he was also the Son of God. Jesus is holy and perfect in every single way. As Christians, we're called to follow Jesus, but how can imperfect people like us be able to follow him? Sometimes we might even feel it is hard to relate to Jesus. If we follow him, we're supposed to live and act like Jesus. People even used to wear bracelets that said WWJD, which means what would Jesus do? But Jesus was perfect. He was seamless. We're not. So it seems really hard to imitate him. But that's what the Bible tells us to do. So how can we imitate Jesus if he seems so different from us?
John, one of Jesus' disciples, wrote to tell people about who Jesus is. John wrote that the word Jesus existed in the beginning, before the world even began. The word has always existed with God, and the word has always existed as God. He was with God in the beginning. When God spoke at creation, all things were created through his word. Not one thing was created apart from him. The word brought life into the world and light for all people. The light shines in the darkness and the darkness could not hide it. God sent a man named John the Baptist to be a witness to the light. John was not the light, but he came to tell people about the light so they might believe. The true light was coming into the world to give light to everyone. When Jesus came into the world, people did not recognize him. His own people did not accept him, but this is good news. To everyone who did accept him, he gave them the right to be a part of God's family, to be children of God. The Word became a human and lived among us. People saw his glory, the glory of the one and only Son of God. He was full of grace and truth. John the Baptist told people that even though Jesus came into the world after him, Jesus is greater because he existed before John. People received blessings from Jesus, grace upon grace. Long ago, God gave people the law through Moses. But now, he has given us grace and truth through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, but Jesus, God's one and only Son, has shown us what God is like. The birth of Jesus was good news. Jesus was no ordinary baby. He was God's Son, sent to earth from heaven. Jesus came into the world as a human to bring us life. He brought light into darkness and showed us what God is like.
Jesus has been around since the beginning. He has seen it all. There is nothing that could happen that would surprise him. I know that seems to be farther away from the point because that makes him feel even less like us, but hear me out. Because he has been around since the beginning and he has seen everything and nothing surprises him, that means he knows the struggle of people. It's one thing to have lived throughout all of history and have knowledge of everything that has ever happened, but Jesus became flesh. He became human. So not only has he seen what humans do, he did what humans do. He was born as a little baby. He grew up. He probably got hurt a time or two. He got to experience happiness and sadness as a human. He understands the things that are hard for us. It is easy to get really comfortable with the human side of Jesus, but we can't forget that he is also God. He deserves our respect. He deserves our attention. Jesus came to earth as fully God and fully human, not only to save each of us from our sins, but also so that we could know God the Father. So why is it so important that Jesus was born fully God and fully human? Because of the cross. Jesus had to be fully human in order to sacrifice himself. If he hadn't been fully human, his death wouldn't have counted. It wouldn't have taken away our sin and saved us. It would have been worthless. He had to be fully God because otherwise he couldn't have endured God's wrath. which is what Jesus took on when he sacrificed himself on the cross. So what do we do with all of this? For those of you who don't really know who Jesus is, I encourage you to keep coming back because each week of this series will answer a big question about God or Jesus or the Bible. So by the end of this series, you will at least know a lot about Jesus. For those of you who already follow Jesus, I hope that this will help you feel closer to Jesus and to help you be more comfortable. For those of you who do know Jesus but haven't yet accepted him as your Savior, maybe knowing this will help inspire you to take that next step. If you have any questions about what it means to accept Jesus as your Savior, I or a small group leader would love to talk to you. That's our sermon. We'll close with a simple prayer. Dear God, thank you for the opportunity to know you more. Please help us learn to be more like you. Help us be thoughtful as we live our lives and think about what would Jesus do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Bye. Have a blessed week.